We have mentioned the newest generation of Intel processors in some of our other videos, but we haven't had a video dedicated to it. We do now. So the newest 12th generation processors from Intel, they have some pretty impressive stuff going on, especially if you run it in Windows 11. They have made the processor, I have one right here, a hybrid, which basically means they've split up the processor in two. It sounds awesome. Let's dive into what it actually means. They have performance cores and they have efficiency cores, which means when you are in need of raw muscle, the computer or Windows makes so that the performance cores will be used. And if you are in need of a single processor with lower power usage, they will use the efficiency cores. Now, they've also made it so that when you're gaming, it shuts down all the background processes that would usually dilute your gaming experience. So this will make everything run smoother for you. And it will also make sure that no other processes will use the performance cores while gaming. Now, this little bad boy right here is an i9-12900F. So what does that actually mean? Well, let's dive into it. The first two digits indicates what generation processor this is. So Intel, they've made processors for ages. So we've reached the 12th generation of processors, and each time they step up the processor game, each core becomes faster. They add all sorts of good stuff. The performance of each core will be increased quite significantly. And you can see it in our powerboard videos in regards to this subject, where we test an 11th generation up against the 12th generation. And you can see how much more the 12th generation actually performs, also because it's run in Windows 11, which utilizes the cores even more. So, as I said, the first two digits indicates the generation. So 12900, that's a 12th generation. And the 900 indicates that it's a i9 processor. So 12900 is 12th generation i9. And this i7 is a 12700. So 12th generation i7. That's pretty easy, right? So we have the i3, the i5, the i7, and the i9, which indicates the levels or the amount of cores. So you get the fewest cores in the i3 and the most cores in i9. Then we get to the suffixes, the last letters that some of these cores have. Now, here at Jog Gaming, you almost always see the K, the KF, or F, or nothing at all. So those are the different letters that we're going to be looking into right here. So let's see here. The i3-10105. It has no letter afterwards. That means this is a normal processor. If it has an F, let's see which one has an F. They're all KFs. I have an F1 right here. This little bad boy. F means that there's no integrated GPU. So if you're using this processor in your computer, you will need a dedicated graphics card to actually run games and stuff that needs graphics. And if you're a gamer, I'm pretty sure you have a graphics card in your computer, then this is not relevant. Those that have an integrated GPU in the processor will be able to run games and use graphics. It's not going to be pretty, but it works. And that's what you can see here. If there are no letters afterwards, it has an integrated GPU. So you can use graphics and play games that require a graphics card, but without having an actual one. So let's recap. F means no integrated GPU. No letter means it has an integrated GPU. Now the last one is K. So if your processor ends with K, it means it is unlocked. And that sounds cool. It also means that you can overclock your processor. Out of the box, it will give you a small boost, but to fully utilize its potential, you will need a set motherboard and you will be able to overclock it. Now, it is worth noting that this is done at your own risk and your warranty will be void, but these CPUs are built for it. So if you respect the limitations and make sure that the system is properly cooled, this will give you an extra boost to your general performance. And I mean that's the point of having a K processor, that is to be able to boost your system. And now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go overclock myself with some more coffee. Thank you for watching.